Good afternoon, everybody. Happy Monday. Hope you all had a great weekend. Have you tabbed open? Thank you, Queen. I do appreciate that. Hope you had a good weekend. Is my mic a little bit better for you? Is that, I know you said when we last spoke just before the weekend. You said my voice wasn't very good. It wasn't close enough. Is it okay now? I've moved it a little bit closer, so it's near my mouth. But until I get myself a boom arm, I'm stuck with it being on the table in front of me at the moment. Oh, I remember. Oh, I could do that. I don't even know what I was using. I've forgotten how to play this game on the TV. What happened the last time? Look at how bloody surrounded. The boss is just picking up, isn't he? Come on. I'm not awake yet.
Any ideas?
I'll see what I can do.
Say that, and he still got it. These predator arrows are pretty cool. It's gonna damage.
Gotta hit it while it's drenched. some more.
I tapped into the core's network hub. I managed to disrupt the Festus' control of the node. You should be able to override it now.
Nice. Thanks. Sounds like it fled to another chamber. Well, I better not get comfortable. Great. Festus covered the floor with lightning. I gotta find a way over it.
Aloy! More machines keep coming! Please tell me you're getting close!
I'm working on it. I've been smashing through a lot of machines on my side, too.
I guess Aaron's missing out!
Aloy, I'm making progress on the bypass, but I need something to hold the cycling module together.
Maybe a ligament from one of the machine carcasses?
Right. Or some luminous braiding!
You could reinforce it with a conversion cylinder.
For increased connectivity! I think we can do this, Aloy!
So, I need a weapon that has ice on it, if I've still got one, that is. I always use them, they're fun to use. Good job. Thank you. That was risky. Give me the option there. Yo, Mikey. Thank you for the lurk, dude. Him. Get hit by him. Shit. Okay. did nothing. What else we got? I'm ready to quit this.
Access restored. Whew. You can override it.
Good work.
You did the heavy lifting.
Can you? Okay. What's that?
Okay. Festus is running out of places to hide.
Aloy? I just registered a huge energy surge back in the production chamber. Something big is happening.
Here too. Everything's glowing.
The machine that Festus was building. It must have finished it.
It's
powerful. Whatever it is. I'm almost done with the core repairs. Should we come to you? Maybe I could distract the machine if...
No, Beta. Just stay where you are, okay? Handling the machine's my job.
Okay. Be safe.
Intruder targeted. The one that captured repair Cauldron Tower. You shall call it my name. You are in violation. But...
I don't have anything icy, do I? Some bloody damage. Wanted to get away from it. Thank you.
done. You did it. There should be one more note to override. Good. Stand by. I'm sending Hephaestus back to you.
See if I can find any boxes that replenish me muscle tissue stuff. At least my medical supplies are back to normal.
Hephaestus! Got it! Hephaestus is back in the core! Make sure it stays there. I'm heading back. And then we can start the merge. Because of you, Beta. I'm glad you came along. And you, Varl. We couldn't have done any of this without you.
Right back at you, Aloy.
Hephaestus.
Aloy, the bypass. The core is stable. Hephaestus is 100% contained. Now we better get started with the merge. It's all set up. Gaia, establish the link, please. The merge, we need to excise Hephaestus's malicious code carefully.
These guys are going to show up.
Well, hello, Red redundant copy. You cost us quite a lot of time. Eric, get Beta. And squash that bug while you're at it.
Flattened.
Ooh.
Get behind me.
Come on, quit screwing around.
Now we're having fun, right?
Finally. Tilda, get Gaia and Hephaestus ready for transport. Tilda!
I failed.
Hush. All is not lost.
Tilda! What the hell are you doing? Stop her!
Beta. Farrell. Where am I?
Ah, you're awake. You took quite a hit when Gerard attacked you. I imagine you must still be in a great deal of pain. I can assure you that we are safe. The others can't detect us here.
You mean the other Zeniths? You must be Tilda.
I wasn't sure if Beta would have told you about me.
Where is she?
Alive. And while she isn't where she wants to be, not in urgent danger. We must discuss how to get her back, of course, after you've shaken off the cobwebs. When you're ready, take the stairs down the hall and come see me. In the meantime, I'll make breakfast.
A new ally?
Breakfast. Okay.
I'm just going to nip to the toilet, so I shall be 2 minutes. Right, I'm back. So it looks like we might have a new ally. Where we are exactly.
What was all this for? Some kind of survival bunker? What is this?
Just a few favorites from my collection. Rescued and stored here just before I went off world. Take a look, if you like. I'm curious to hear your impressions.
My friend is dead. Beta and Gaia are gone, and you want me to look at old paintings?
Don't be so quick to dismiss the comfort we can find in art. Or the insight we might gain.
Okay.
My favorite pairing on the left is woman reading a letter by Vermeer, a true master. And on the right is a forgery, woman reading music, which fooled experts into believing it was a priceless original. Early in my career, I became fascinated with such deceptions. Eventually, I developed scanning software that could detect fakes with unparalleled accuracy.
Is that how you made enough money to buy your way onto the Odyssey?
Oh, no. I made my real fortune later. Selene and Endymion. She's the goddess of the moon, whereas he's a simple shepherd. Beside her is the god of love, Cupid.
So she's sneaking up on him?
More like visiting him in secret. The torch that Cupid bears represents Selene's undying infatuation with him. Though the two must remain apart, her love will forever burn. This is Rembrandt painting Jeremiah, a man in mourning.
Mourning what?
His home. The ancient city of Jerusalem. He foresaw its impending doom, but could do nothing to prevent it. So instead, he saved its treasures from destruction, just as I saved these works. You could say we're kindred spirits. Portrait of the painter, Rembrandt's son Titus, depicted in the habit of a monk.
I don't get it. Why would someone like you, with infinite resources, care about this painting of a boy in a hood?
It's not the image itself, but the feeling it conveys. The face is bright and defined, but his eyes are downcast, heavy with misfortune. And the background seems to swallow all light. The painting is infused with a sense of loss.
I guess I understand how the painter feels.
Rembrandt's The Night Watch, by far the most famous painting my homeland ever produced. It was commissioned to honor a militia made up of influential citizens.
I guess you must have been an influential citizen.
In my day. But not as influential as you've been in this new world. The Gust. By Willem van de Velde, the most famous of his many maritime paintings.
A ship crossing into the unknown. I guess you're familiar with that.
Indeed, which is why I appreciate this composition in particular. Though waves and wind threaten to destroy the ship, it perseveres, clinging to the light even as darkness closes in all around it. Stunning, isn't it? Paintings were the only masterpieces of my people's golden age. This is von Vianen's lidded ewer, molded from a single sheet of silver.
What was it for?
How like Elizabeth you are. Function over form. Its practical purpose was less important than its meaning. Von Vianen created it in honor of his late brother, who himself was a famous silversmith.
A memorial?
Yes. Such beauty from sorrow.
A lot of weight on his shoulders. I know the feeling.
Done so soon?
I've got more important things to worry about.
We both do. There is much we are trying to save. Not the least of which is in that vault. There's nothing wrong with savoring such treasures for a moment more. Or come upstairs and we'll get down to business. Your choice.
There you are. Feeling better? How did you find us? At the cauldron? And what did you do to everyone right before I passed out?
All business, I see. Well, suffice it to say we were keeping a very close eye on Hephaestus, knowing we would need it at some point. Your ruse didn't fool us, and as for my little trick, it was an overload of the senses, accompanied by an energy discharge. Gerard and Eric were only momentarily disoriented due to their shields, but it rendered you unconscious while I got you out. Perhaps some breakfast might steady you a bit?
This was your house. The one you recreated for Beta, in the data channel you shared.
How perceptive of you. Please, this way.
After everything your people have done, you think I'm just gonna sit down and have a chat with you?
They're not my people. They never were, and especially not now.
You shot off into space with them, and live with them for 1,000 years before coming back. So what made you suddenly turn on them?
Quite simply, this.
My old focus. You repaired it? But that means you've seen
incredible things. What you've accomplished in 2 decades of life. A 1,000 years at my back, and I haven't even come close.
Thank you for the heart spray.
I'm sorry if I invaded your privacy, but I had to. In order to understand, to be enlightened. You truly are Elizabeth's blood. With her drive, her sense of mission, her integrity. Watching all this shamed me for the company that I've kept. Having seen it, all I want is to help you.
Even even if it means stopping your friends.
Especially so. Please, sit down. There. That's better. Now, we must recover Beta and Gaia at all costs. By now, you must know that Gerard intends to use Gaia to reboot the Earth's biosphere. Remaking this world to specifications that would only suit us immortals. This process will kill every living thing on the planet. He calls it a clean install.
Not if I stop him first.
Not if we do. And once he and the others are gone, we can work together to fulfill Elizabeth's dream. I'm sure Beta told you that there's a build of the Apollo database on board our ship. A complete collection of human knowledge. With that and Gaia, we could do everything Elizabeth wanted. Heal the biosphere, educate the people of this world, uplift them. Create the world she imagined.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. From what I've seen, your friends are invincible.
I do wish you would stop calling them my friends. And they're not invincible. In fact, a friend of yours has found a way to defeat them.
Silence.
Oh, he's been a busy bee, building an army powerful enough to crash through Gerard's precious base.
Regala and her rebels.
Even now, she's preparing a final march on the Tanakhth capital. When she wins, she'll have the entire tribe under her control. Hundreds of warriors and machines to throw at the base. She's been duped. They'll all perish, of course. But it should be enough to break Gerard's defenses and allow Silence to kill him. Along with all the others.
Using the new weapon he's developed.
Yes, he's found a way to circumvent our shields. Truly an exceptional man. He's planned for everything. Except you and me. You see, while his army is battering down Gerard's doors, you and I will sneak in through a back way. One that only I know about. While Silence
and she's got like a crazy glow around her.
Battling each other. We'll take back Beta and Gaia. I told you I want to help you.
You said Beta is not in urgent danger, so what are the Zeniths doing to her?
Putting her to work. Merging Hephaestus with Gaia. A difficult, time-consuming task, as I'm sure you know. They will compel her if need be, but her life is not in danger. She's the only one who can do it.
Because you people made her to be nothing but a tool.
Gerard's idea, not mine. They always viewed me with suspicion when I attempted any form of kindness towards her. That's why I created the data channel. A virtual place where we could speak in peace.
So this channel you shared with Beta, none of the others ever found out about it.
Gerard believes he's the most cunning of all of us. Even after 1,000 years, he still can't imagine that I would outwit him. The channel allowed me to interact with Beta away from their mistrustful eyes. It offered us a chance to be ourselves.
Until you cut off all contact.
Yes. Though it pained me. I was worried that our meetings would do her more harm than good.
She felt like you tossed her aside.
I was afraid the others would find out and punish her. She may not have had the comforts of friendship anymore, but at least I ensured she was safe. I know it seems harsh, but you must believe that her well-being has always been paramount to me.
Why did you make the data channel look like this place?
I built this house as a shelter to weather any storm. A safe place. Not just for me, but for the art stored below. cultural artifacts of incalculable value. Truly some of the greatest achievements of human civilization.
And you wanted Beta to see them?
Yes. Her upbringing was so cold and technical. I thought if she could experience Vermeer and Rembrandt, it would bring something else into her life. A heritage every bit as valuable as the scientific and technical data being drummed into her. I'm sorry I had to cut off contact, but I'll never regret sharing this house with her. She needed its shelter even more than I did.
Beta told me your colony was destroyed. That you came back to Earth because you had nowhere else to go.
It's true. After we reached our destination, a planet in the Sirius star system, we spent decades building a new home. The physical constraints of Earth, the boundaries of mortality, gone. To think of what we could have done with it. It might have been a utopia. Instead, we stagnated, absorbed in effortless comforts and virtual realities. It took a cataclysm to finally yank us out of our stupor.
What happened?
A massive geological event. We knew of instabilities in the planet core, but we underestimated them. By the time the collapse was upon us, it was too late to stop it. Only a few of us made it to the ship in time. We set course for Earth, the only safe harbor left to us.
Which you decided to make unsafe for anyone else.
Not me. Gerard. He believes it's better to wipe the canvas clean than work around the smudges. No more primitive tribes, no more combat machines, only a blank slate to do with as he pleases. But we will stop him. All we have to do is get into that base.
What exactly is your plan to sneak into the Zenith base?
We will make use of a lesson I learned from an early age. Always know your exits. In this case, a place where Gerard's new construction meets the ancient foundation, a passage that only I can access. When Silence flings his army at the base, we will enter through this back door, bypassing most of the fighting. The distraction will provide us with a window in which to rescue Beta and Gaia.
Once we're inside the base, where will we find Beta and Gaia?
Here, in the command center. By then, Gaia will have been reunited with all of its subordinate functions, including Hephaestus.
What about the alpha build of Apollo on your ship?
A simple matter of recovery, once the others have been dealt with. With that in hand, we'll have everything we need to make this world as it should be.
How do you know about Silence's plan?
He isn't the only one adept at spyware.
You hacked his focus?
No, he's too careful for that. But his subordinates? Not so much. He gave additional focuses to the tribals he branded the Sons of Prometheus. By tapping them, I learned about most of his dealings. The distribution of override technology, the arming of Tanakh rebels, and the secret pact with Regala to attack Gerard's base.
But how did he come up with a weapon that can take down your shields?
That's the one thing I haven't been able to figure out, but however he did it, I'm quite certain it will work. With it in the Tanakh army, victory seems to be within his grasp. Such a shame he'll be disappointed.
Regala's only interested in killing Hikaru and waging war on the Karja. What does she have to gain by attacking Zenith?
It's the price she must pay for her war. Without the ability to override machines, her little rebellion would have languished in the desert.
So she trades with the Sons of Prometheus. Machines to help her overthrow Hikaru.
In exchange for an assault on the base. Pride has deluded her into thinking she can actually survive such a battle. And all without ever knowing who the Sons of Prometheus really answer to. Yet for all of Silence's brilliance, still he underestimates you. That blind spot is what will allow us to take Beta and Gaia right out from under him.
While hundreds of Tanakh are cut down outside. So you knew Elizabeth. What was she like?
Liz was everything she was. I see in you. And more. Your ingenuity, your determination, your moral compass. You've managed to distill her greatest qualities and make them your own.
I'm not asking about me. Tell me about Elizabeth. What was she really like?
The honest answer is that I don't actually know. For all the time that I spent with her, she always kept a part of herself locked away. It was like that from the moment we met.
So when you met Elizabeth, she was what? Distant? Aloof?
Not aloof. Not exactly. It was a summit in Paris about machine learning. A touchy subject in those days. Because regulatory authorities were just starting to clamp down on AIs. Liz gave the keynote address. She had already achieved great renown for her work in automated environmental reclamation. But in her address, she was just starting to imagine the next step. An AI-driven system that wouldn't just act on its programming, but actually take responsibility for its sphere of influence.
To care about life, not just follow orders.
Revolutionary stuff. I was fascinated. And I wanted to meet her for a long time. I watched her after her talk. She had spoken with such moral authority, such empathy. But after that, she retreated. I could tell she felt uncomfortable with all of her admirers. It was as if giving the talk had cost her something. I didn't want to be a pest, so I planned my approach carefully.
So how did you finally approach Elizabeth after her talk?
I picked the right moment. The morning of the next day, right as she came back to the conference, she had just had her coffee. She was fresh, rested. It was like she had braced herself for the onslaught of colleagues. I asked if I could walk with her, then put forth a question about her talk that I thought was intelligent. Her answer made me realize it wasn't, but she was very welcoming. Almost as if we were previously acquainted. It was only halfway through the conversation that I realized she knew exactly who I was. It was quite a shock to me. My business was trafficking in secrets, and I took great pains to protect my anonymity. So that was Liz, perpetually one step ahead. I came to view our meeting as a metaphor for our friendship. She always seemed to know me far better than I knew her.
I guess I know the feeling. My old focus. How did you find it, let alone repair it?
When we encountered you at the Hades Proving Lab, Gerard saw you as a redundancy. I knew better. You were a revelation. After your dramatic escape, bravo, by the way. Gerard and Eric assumed you were dead and gave up the hunt. I wasn't so sure. When the others were busy, I returned to the lab and searched for any trace of you. That's when I found this little treasure. Not easy to repair, but certainly worth the effort. As I watched your life unfold, you were like a splash of color on a worn canvas. What Liz was, and more.
Did you show it to the others?
Of course not. It was your actions that inspired me to defy them. It's worth noting that if I hadn't found it and watched its contents, I wouldn't have known to save you at the cauldron. You'd be dead.
So I should be grateful?
If you like.
Oh.
So you know all about me, What about
you? There's a lot of dialogue in this.
What would you like to know?
Well, start with your life on Earth.
When I was 8, terrorists flooded my home city. Thousands drowned, my parents included. I was one of the few who survived. My guardian sent me to boarding school. Among my peers, I was the strange girl, the orphan to be avoided. All because of circumstances beyond my control.
Oh. So we're a lot alike, huh?
Aren't we? You were an outcast. But you didn't let that stop you from getting what you needed. Neither did I. I climbed my way out of desolation and used my wits to build a fortune. First, from the technical analysis of art and the detection of forgeries. Profitable expertise in those days. But as it turned out, the software I developed was even more useful for counterintelligence. From there, it was only a short step to gathering extremely valuable intelligence on my own.
You were a spy?
More like a service one could turn to for information. I had to remain anonymous, of course, to protect my privacy. But despite that anonymity, Far Zenith inevitably sought me out.
What happened when Far Zenith approached you?
They painted an irresistible vision of humanity's future. One where we need not fear illness or death, where we explored the furthest reaches of the stars and thrived. It was only later that I realized that they only intended to bequeath this future to the rich and powerful. At the time I finally figured it out, the walls were closing in, Pharaoh's machines were devouring the Earth. So I accepted Far Zenith's invitation to a birth on the Odyssey. I wanted Liz to come, but she had nobler plans, as you well know.
So you didn't know the other Zeniths were monsters until it was too late?
I knew some of them were. Certainly. It wasn't until we were off-planet that I understood the true scope of their greed. I was grateful to simply be alive, but the others became obsessed with a kind of effortless immortality. They built a colony where machines serviced their every need, where any memory or fantasy could be endlessly savored in virtual reality. It wasn't life. It was stultifying, a pampered dream state. As the decades passed, I withdrew more and more, alone yet again, but this time with eons to consider my mistakes. Now finally, having met you, I feel like I have a second chance.
To do what?
Help you. To fulfill Liz's dream, which isn't so different from Far Zenith's original vision. A better future for humanity.
First Pharaoh. Now Hikaru and the Tanakh. Your plan would wipe out an entire tribe. There has to be another way.
We are in an admittedly desperate situation, but I assure you there isn't. Remember Zero Dawn. Elizabeth's sacrifice. Sometimes many have to die for a new world to grow.
If it looks impossible, wait. The data channel. It still exists, doesn't it? I need you to open it. Let me talk to Beta.
Impossible. We might be detected.
It's worth the risk. There is another way, one where the Tanakh survive.
But we won't. If the others...
If you want to help, open it.
Boo.
What are they doing to her? Virtual reality dissociation. The manual merge of Hephaestus will take hours upon hours of tedious micromanagement. If she resists the work, they run simulations to induce feelings of isolation and despair.
Beta, can you hear me?
They're watching me. I can't hold up this extra protection for long. You should have killed me.
No. No, look at me. I'm coming for you. I promise. Okay? I just need you to hold out a little while longer and work on the merge. Contact again when it's time. Can you hold on?
As long as I know you're coming for me, I can endure anything.
All right. I did as you asked. Now I think you need to tell me what you're planning.
I'm going to take Sylon's army away. I don't need it. Only the weapon he made to penetrate your shields.
And how do you propose to get it? Ask him nicely?
Without Regala and her rebels, he won't have a choice. We'll be his only option.
Only option for what? What did you tell her?
That is between me and my sister. Will be Sylon's only option for crashing that base. I'll tell you the rest later. But first, there are a couple of things I have to do.
Oh. And what are those?
Lay my friend to rest. And then I'm going to use the override that Beta gave me at Gemini to put an end to Regala's rebellion. From the air.
Wait. Since you insist on doing things your way, I know of something that will truly help you make a grand entrance with the Tenakt. The ancient Horus Titans still possess electromagnetic energy cells as part of their arsenal. Drop one of those on Regala's army and they'll receive quite a surprise. So go, do what you must. I'll come to your base if you manage to bring silence to the table.
Not if. When. Erend, are you there?
Aloy! Aloy, is that really you?
Yeah, it's me. Where's everyone else?
We're all... We're back at base. What happened?
It might be easier to explain in person. I'll try to join you there when I can.
Okay. We'll wait here for you. It's good to hear your voice, Aloy.
Okay, then. That was a ton of dialogue. I suppose we will head back to base and make the bad news about.
Just to let you know, I'm now patched into your focus network.
Right. I take it the other Xenos can't hear us?
Of course not. And they don't know about your base either, in case you were wondering. I've sent you data on the Horus energy cells you can use against Regala's forces. Reach out to me when you're ready to acquire one.
Understood.
If there's anything else. Yes, in the cinema, maybe. There's nothing up here. One of the watches stuck in the wall. Rip his armor off. The wrong one. Thank you. need better weapons. Okay. Okay. Right. I'm going to nip to the loo. I'll be 2 minutes again. I'll have to rip its armor off again. Get that antenna taken. Back up. Assuming I'll probably have to scan everything again. Sort this out first. Okay, that's new.
Machine will take a lot of damage from acid.
Nemeth. You heard. You sure? Oh, got it there. It was a bell back before, so I wonder why. Thank you. I regret this decision. Getting hit by rocks. I was after. Yo, Scorpio, how's it going, dude? Did you have a good weekend? Felt dirty doing that, but you know, what the hell.
Ooh. I'll take this.
Yeah, I almost went south because of the fact I forgot and almost had to go to church with my grandparents. Ooh. Well, each to their own, I suppose. I mean, I'm not a church girl, let's put it that way. Ooh, very nice. Got some good shit out of that. Still not enough machine muscle, though. they're still around. Why did I roll into that? I saw it coming and I still rolled into it. Still great, nice. Yeah, I'm still tired as hell, so gonna get a bit more sleep. No worries, dude. Well, thanks for dropping in. I'm glad you had a good weekend, minus being almost forced to go to church. Only 7:30 a.m. Yeah, my cat had a had the good idea of waking me up at 7 o'clock this morning, so a little bit cranky today. Birds woke up at 6. Nah. Yeah, go to sleep for a bit, man. It's a bit early if you haven't got anything to do. What's that, Scorpio? Book sleep for now. You can always have a afternoon nap. Quick power nap, as I call it. I don't even know where I am in the map. Ooh. What do you say about Dragon Ball Fighters? Yeah, can do. I say finish my stream in about an hour and a half. Yeah, we can do some of that. I'm not very good at fighting games though, so you probably will kick my ass.
I'll save the extra stock for later.
That's if I don't actually have a power nap myself. Missing. Oh. My God. Help. Who? I'm confused. I just shot that fox twice. It's got a name. Gonna follow it and see what happens. Looks like it's got a name. Secretly Alice in Wonderland. Yeah. That fox. I pet it. I mean, he's got a couple of arrows sticking out of its ass. Unless it's like a homage to Ghost of Tsushima, because that had, you know, like foxes and stuff that you used to follow. Can't do anything with it though. I may have mistakenly shot him in the ass a couple of times. I think the arrows have disappeared now.
I'm gonna fill up while I can.
Yep, can't do anything with it. Just like a little Easter egg or something. Wide moors over there. An apex one. Oh, there it is. So I found a magical fox. I'll save it anyway. Hey, real question. Go for it. Have you watched the best trailer in Smash Bros. History? I've watched a trailer of Smash Bros. I think when Sephiroth was announced for it. But I don't know what the best one is, because I haven't watched many.
Acid could work against that machine.
That's the one I'm talking about. Ah, right. Okay. I get you. Yeah, it is good. You kind of get, you know, goosebumps from watching it. I know I did. It's like, ooh! But But it's like, I think it's like a fiver for a character or something, which seems a bit much. Hey, there's something wrong with me. I'm just going to nip to the loo, dude. Give me 2 minutes. Right, I'm back. I'm gonna just try, so. Yo. What was white for? Oh, I am in the wrong area. Get away from them. Got goosebumps. Galeen died. Who is that? Sephiroth comes in and sees, hey, that was the boss, right? Well, I'm the boss now. Oh, is that the hand? Going in there and I don't have a plan. Wrong one. Can you stop me? Oh shit. I don't know where I was aiming there.
I can switch it up.
Come on. damage. One down. Job like that. I can't believe in 2024 it's going to be Dragon Ball's 35th anniversary. Bloody hell. That is 35 years. It's not like the hardest thing to get. And even harder when they're shooting rocks at you. I couldn't get there. I think I got one tusk there. Nice. I just can't wait for the... Just can't wait for the anime to make Granola and the Moro arc. Did I say that right? Yeah, I'm kind of hoping that they'll make more Dragon Ball. Because I mean, it's been a couple of years since Super. Right, I'm going to, I'm just going to get myself over to the base, which is like miles away. didn't render in properly. Here we go, here's the sad times. I'm not going to do any talking while this is on.
When you're wounded, you have to strike back. Draw blood.
Hey! Can't I get one damn minute to mourn my friend?
Regala is going to slaughter my tribe to overthrow Hikaru. The Zeniths have Beta and Gaia. We can't sit around wallowing in our losses.
Katalo's right. We must fight.
Oh, all right. So what are we going to do, huh? Take on all of Regala's rebels?
Not to mention the Zeniths. What can we even do? Throw ourselves at their base?
Something like that. So... after we lost contact with you, we regrouped and went to Gemini. What happened? The recording we found on Varl's Focus cut off when that Zenith Eric... The Zeniths were tracking Hephaestus. When Gaia trapped it in Gemini, they knew where we were. After Varl tried to stop them, they took Beta and Gaia. I only survived because one of the Zeniths turned against the others to save me.
One of them? Well, at least we didn't lose you too. So what do we do now?
We're going to defeat the Zeniths and get Beta and Gaia back. But first, we're going to stop Regala.
How?
Back in Gemini, Beta gave me a gift. There's something I need to do first to make it work, but it could put an end to the bloodshed.
Word is, Regala's readying her army for an all-out assault on the Grove. I need to be there.
I know. Go. Stand with Hikaru. And keep an eye on the sky.
Strike true as the Ten.
The rest of you, whatever preparations you need to make, upgrades, resupplies, get on it. It won't be long before we take the fight to the Zeniths.
We'll be ready, Aloy. And when you're ready, meet me outside the east exit. I'd like to have a word in private.
Even when things are darkest, you're the flame that lights the way forward.
Just tell me one thing. Am I gonna get to smash up a bunch of Zenith bastards?
We all are.
Good.
Before I do anything else, I should check on Zoe. It sounded important.
Thank you.
It's all going to be okay.
You look busy.
My studies are a good distraction. Especially after Cauldron Gemini. Varl, Beta, Gaia... gone. And that's just the beginning. The Zeniths want to rob us of our future, too.
We won't let that happen.
Oh, and if you have a moment, there's something I could use your help with.
You mentioned there was something you needed help with?
Yes. So, as I was sifting through data from the greenhouse, I found references to an old world system back in the Great Delta. It's called Leviathan. My people discovered it decades ago. A sprawling network of river gates and a labyrinth of underground tunnels. The legacy revealed that the old ones used it to control flooding. But we've never gotten it to work. The whole thing is shut down. But the data from the greenhouse mentions the research facility where Leviathan was created. It's in San Francisco.
Another Pharaoh facility?
No. Leviathan was a project by Eileen Sasaki, another ancestor. So the legacy tells us, anyway. If we can acquire that data, we might be able to fix the system back in the Great Delta. Every year, my sister gets terrified when the long rains begin. With Leviathan, maybe she won't have to be.
Okay. So where in San Francisco is this facility?
That's the thing. The data doesn't say where, exactly. But one of our diviners has been exploring the ruins. He might know. Would you come with me? I have a feeling that wherever this facility is, well, you're much better at fighting machines than I am.
Of course. I'll let you know when I'm in landfall.
Thank you, Aloy.
I should get going. Be ready to go on my signal, okay?
I won't let you down.
I know. And like I said, I'll let you know when I'm in landfall. We'll find the data you're after.
I appreciate it.
Where the hell is Katalo? In one of the rooms, I know he is. Unless she... Oh.
Over here, Aloy. We would come out here to tend to the garden. Sometimes I needed fresh air. Other times we would simply sit and watch the sunrise. So when we returned from Gemini, it seemed fitting that he be laid to rest here. Now he can always look out at Plainsong and... further east, to the Nora Sacred Lands.
He would have liked that.
He often spoke of his sister, Vala. He said she used to gather her favorite golden blooms and tie them to her spear. Their mother called it useless, but Vala was stubborn.
Yeah, she seemed like that.
It wasn't easy, but I tracked down the flower, gathered its seeds.
As verdant limbs wither, roots rot in snow, still the seed rises as certain as stone.
From death follows new life. So it is with the land. And so it is with us. I'm with child, Aloy. I was going to tell him when he got back from Gemini. Instead, one day, I'll bring our child here. We'll sit among the blooms and watch the sunrise.
I never got to tell him. To thank him. For saving my life, sure, but also... for not giving up on me.
He always knew.
Promise to look after them. I'll try to visit again when I can. But for now, I need to go to the fabrication terminal to install the new override on my spear. Then I'll use it on a sunwing and get ready for an entrance Regala will never forget. Turning into an icicle out here.
stop trouble with Catalo, always kicking my ass.
Who says I'm any good at it?
The way my luck's going.
I keep thinking,
plugging in that
Well, I see if I can get myself some new weapons. Didn't get anything from the herbalist. Sell something. More shots than that.
When danger's on the way, remember to use that. It's not like you need a boost, but that will give you one. This time I will
need
them.
Okay. Good. Buy some new stuff off him. Don't have jungle birds though.
Let our blades seek Regala.
Good day, Outlander.
I missed it. I was stuck on guard.
slashing your throats.
There you are. It's a better ice. I need a Sunwing Circuitor. Oh, yes.
Handy and life-saving.
You fucking upgrade me armor. Is it worth really upgrading it? Can I get me? Right, that's max out. The last one. God, I had that.
That look, it's time to change it, right?
I heard from our scouts that the rebels are on the move.
Muscle. Maurice. Last pace now.
We'll be stuck here on duty. Her blade be bright.
come up. All areas I've not actually been and explored around. This Vegas is actually I might go back there. See what I can. Some of those things that I picked up, they're collectibles. I'd head over there and see what I can do with them. This has changed.
You can ride machines, right? Apparently, you're not the only one. But you probably knew that.
The wilds are different.
You ever wonder if this is worth it for you? Missing these moments over a few shards? A few shards are gonna buy a better
thing. Is riding machines a thing now? I saw other people doing it.
Someone's in a rush.
Hey, good luck opening trade with you, huh?
Sure, a teller of tales, who smiled warmly with the promise of another adventure.
Stemmer, did you need something?
As a new dream dawned for the adventuring trio, they returned to the depths of the formerly sunken city, where fortune was found behind every crumbling wall as a bulging keg bursts with free-flowing ale. That is, we broke our way into more of the ruins below, and in one of them, the wordsmith beheld a glimmering gizmo, a wonder among a sea of wonders. Alas, the gizmo lay beyond his grasp.
You saw some kind of gizmo but couldn't get it?
A door bars the way, locked by some confounded means. Moreland contemplated explosives, but Abaddon thought the odds of crushing the gizmo under rubble were too high. For once, the shard counter skepticism might be warranted. The old wordsmith's hopes were dashed until a friend with a knack for performing the impossible returned from beyond the sands. Might I persuade you to venture beneath the desert once more?
I'll see what I can do. Where is this place?
Once you're down there, take a right at the statue of the giant man. The ruin rests beside a metal tower. And so our heroine went forth, and the wordsmith's hopes went with her.
See how different this is. I'm going the right way. Looks like.
Okay. There's the giant statue that Stemmer mentioned. The ruin should be nearby. Inside a metal tower. The gizmo Stemmer's after should be inside.
Step point. One of them.
An image from the old world. Looks like part of the city inside the dome.
If I can. There's the iPhone. Right. Gonna be.
Maybe I'm too low to light up the image?
Yeah.
I can get a good view of the city from this overhang. Maybe I should try to line up the image here.
A bit more over. This is further over than there.
This easy? I think I might be too low to line up the image.
You'd be higher.
Too far. I could try to line up the vista point image again. I should be within range.
Could be. Huh?
That did it.
Completing the image unlocked a data file. It looks like these vista points were made by Miriam Technologies. That was Elizabeth's company. I wonder if I can find more of them out in the wild.
That's pretty cool. Right, let's go get that thing.
Frost won't help here. Machine was born for the cold.
I didn't realize there was enemies around here. Thought they would have all been gone. Easy. Not a tough one.
I think I'm in the right place. Now, where's that gizmo? There. That must be the gizmo. Looks like this door needs a code to open. I should check around the ruin, see if I can find anything that might help.
Doing before.
What's in here? Huh. So the gizmo is actually called an ornament. I found one of these in another ruin. It sounds like there are more out there. And it looks like there's part of a code. Might be for the door. I better keep looking around. Maybe I can find the rest of it. A hatch. Might lead to another part of the ruin. But how to get to it? I'll hook onto that. I can't pull this out. Looks like the crate on top's blocked. Top crate up. There we go.
That one. Never mind.
There's an opening at the top of the fence. Could be a way in, if I can find a way to get up there.
Hmm. nothing. Can I?
There. Should be able to reach the opening now. Budge from the side. See where this leads. Oh, I'm back outside. What else is up here? Looks like the ornaments were part of something called the Knights of Lights holiday promotion.
Hmm.
A way to celebrate old world holidays by changing the holograms above ground. But how? Well, the other part of the code's here too. I should have what I need to open the door.
Better double check that first. Again. go grab myself some food. Because I is hungry. But thank you very much for joining me today. I hope you all had a great weekend. And I will see you all next time. It'll be probably be Thursday when I'm next on, because I've got some stuff on Wednesday to do, which is important. So I'll change my stream from Wednesday to Thursday this week, and then I'll be doing the usual Friday as well. I think I'm online tomorrow night with a good friend, so probably be playing the infamous Resident Evil 6. So until then, I will see you all then. Bye for now.